Missing No? Is that you? What is up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, and today we're going to go over what exactly is going on with this glitch Pokemon on the Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield game website. First things first, let's jump over to Twitter to check out the post by the official Pokemon company saying this. New Pokemon discovered. Head this way for the latest on our Galar research trainers. With a link to the official Pokemon website, and heading to the website, you will notice that on the bottom right hand corner, you will see what it looks like to be a pixelated art for Pokemon. Hovering your mouse over to click the image will move the art to the top left of the screen and then again to the bottom left of the screen. Upon clicking the moving image, you'll be taken to a brand new Pokemon page, with the screen doing a very unique transition while playing a Pokemon's cry. The Pokemon cry that you hear is actually Rotom's cry. Also, data from the website naming the sound asset as actually Rotom's cry. So there you go. Now this brings up a very interesting question, because what link may Rotom have with this Pokemon? I believe it could be a few things going on here. My first thought is maybe because the Pokedex inside of the titles, Pokemon Sword and Shield, will actually be a part of the Rotom phone. So maybe we're just hearing the sound of Rotom due to Rotom being glitched somehow and somehow doesn't know the correct cry to play. So it's playing its own default cry. Maybe, just maybe. Or maybe this Pokemon is a new type of Rotom. Maybe it's a fighting Rotom. With all the different types of Rotom we've been seeing in the trailers for Pokemon Sword and Shield, I kind of highly doubt that we get a brand new form of Rotom being playable, being a fighting Pokemon that we can throw out in battle, because now they're just integrating Rotom into everyday use and pretty much anything that has anything to do with technology, pretty much. We got the Rotom Pokedex, we got the Rotom bike, we got the Rotom phone, we got the Rotom PC. And due to the nature of all these types of Rotom that we've been seeing throughout the game, I highly doubt that we'll just be introduced randomly to a brand new one that we're going to be using for battle. But I could be wrong. I mean, why not have a Rotom PC that we can use for battle? Or why not have a Rotom phone that we can use for battle? I mean, we do got a fan, we do got a washing machine, we do got a lawnmower, so it's not out of the realm of possibility. But enough on the Rotom, let's move on to what exactly is going on with the page, because we do have a lot of interesting details to go over. We can't go over the name of the Pokemon because it's glitched out and blanked out, and we're going to be seeing that a lot on this page. The next thing it leaves us is with this image, this pixelated Cubone looking thing. The top green and white bar could be a sword or spear of some sort, and on the bottom half of the body there's two tones of green. And again, I could be reaching, but it looks like maybe the lighter green could be a shield or something in the Pokemon's hand. I don't know. We can't really tell because, again, everything is totally pixelated and glitched out. But due to some sleuthing from the community, people noticed that if you were to turn the image to the side, you get more of a duck-looking Pokemon rather than the Cubone. The duck-looking Pokemon looks to be holding a sword in its hand, and what looks more definitive as a shield in its other hand. And because of past leaks, a lot of people are pointing out that this duck may indeed be the evolution of Farfetch, Sirfetch, or the Galarian form of Farfetch. Now moving on off this image, let's look into the bio of this Pokemon because we have some more information here. On the category, we get another glitch text Pokemon. Clearly, they're trying to hide the type of this Pokemon. Clearly, this would be labeled as to not give us any hints pointing to any particular Pokemon this may be. The type of Pokemon, again, is a fighting type, with it falling in line with it looking like a spear and a sword in his hand or a shield, depending on how you look at the image. The height of the Pokemon is glitched out, so they don't want us to know how tall or short the Pokemon may be, which also leads me to believe that this may be a Galarian form of a particular Pokemon, because again, if we knew the height of the Pokemon, it would be comparable to another Pokemon that is already existent in the Pokedex. But because we don't have the height, we can't compare it. So if it was something brand new, showcasing the Pokemon's height wouldn't be considered a spoiler. So that's a thing to consider there. The weight of the Pokemon being one of the most interesting parts of it being 257.9 LBS, considering that Cubone and Farfetch weigh way less than this. But the weight could be added on because they're holding a huge sword and a huge shield in their hand. And then it has the ability of Steadfast, which isn't anything too special. It just increases the use of your speed stat by one stage when flinch, which again is nothing to write home about. And if we look up the Pokemon that has this ability, we could see a few of them are indeed fighting type Pokemon with Cypher, Mega Mewtwo X, Gallade, and Rockruff and Lycanroc being the only outliers, which again, do note there's no Cubone, Marowak, or Farfetch on this list. Now, maybe the most important clue that we may have gotten, on the bottom we get a text that reads, "Only blank that have survived many battles can tame this blank when this Pokemon blanks blanks ERS," finishing that last blank, "will retire from combat." Now you can put pretty much anything in these blanks and it will kind of work. One thing a lot of people have been agreeing on is that the blank that ends with the ERS might be shattered. And maybe the word in front of that blank is sword, because if your sword was to shatter, you will not be able to battle in combat. Or if your shield was to shatter, you also wouldn't be able to return to combat. Now, if it is a Cubone, a Galarian Cubone, maybe if its skull shatters, it will retire from combat. If it's a Farfetch, maybe if its leak shatters, it will retire from combat. We don't really know at this point what exactly this is, but again, it's very interesting that the Pokemon Company chose to roll out this Pokemon in this particular way, knowing that the community would do just this, talk about it and try to sleuth up what exactly is going on. We kind of did this about last year's time when Meltan was being rolled out in such a weird way, being rolled into Pokemon Go and being turned into Ditto inside of the Pokemon Go game. We all was questioning and doubting ourselves if this was in fact a real Pokemon. Look at it now, it's the Pokemon Meltan and evolution, it's even categorized as mythical. Who would have seen that coming? I can't wait to see what exactly this Pokemon is, if it is a new Galarian Cubone, if it is a new Galarian Farfetch or an evolution to Farfetch or something brand new entirely. I can't wait no matter what. I'm kind of leaning towards it being a Farfetch evolution. So again, Farfetch can get some love. Me being a Gen 1 baby and loving Gen 1, obviously I would love to see a Gen 1 Pokemon get some shine and some more love, even though they always do, I know. But, you know, I can't help to help my, you know, one of my little fellow Gen 1 babies to get some little love with a brand new dope evolution that we've all been waiting for. Especially with the Generation 2 demo version, Space Moon, or whatever it's called, games that were data mined and us getting a slew of Pokemon, one of them being an evolution to Farfetch that we actually never got to see inside of those games. So again, it would be a great callback to that, and a callback to, again, a long-lost Pokemon that we all want to see. Now, that's going to be it for today. I want to hear from you guys in the comment section below. Let me know your thoughts on this glitch Pokemon. Do you think it's a Cubone, a Farfetch, a brand new Pokemon? I want to hear from you guys in the comment section below. As you guys know, I answer all comments, so let's talk it up down there. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that like button. It does help me out a ton as far as moving the video into recommended for other people who can enjoy the video. If you want to see more videos from me, please hit that subscribe button. You'll be helping me out a ton, especially on the road to 1K. I believe I'm like at 965, so a few more subs and I'll be at 1K. If you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video, ring the bell also. That's going to be it for me today, guys. Peace. I love you guys. I'm going to see you guys on the next Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield news update video. Like always, guys, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on Instagram and Twitter, and you guys can bring the conversation there. I'm the American Gamer in Switzerland right here on YouTube, and yes, I'm going to be doing a ton of videos just like this one. So if you enjoy, please hit that subscribe button. Also, hit the like button. It does help me out a ton as far as growing the channel is concerned. Ring the bell if you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video. Peace. I'm going to see you guys on the next one. Yes?
Yes, on the way. Sophia, order. What's your order?
Can I make salad dinner with meat and ramen, please? And toasted bread.
In toasted bread?
Family, I'll see them and ramen, please.
Okay.
I'll meet egg and cheese, please.
Okay. Okay.
Now, I'm very hungry.
Okay.
All right.
All right, bye.